Hello friends, welcome to Smart Catalyst. Today we'll be seeing the current affairs of 31st December 2018. The articles we'll be seeing for prelims are these five. The first article is about the shrinkage of Lake Urmia in the state of Iran. Second article talks about the illegal rat hole mining in the state of Meghalaya. Third article is about the lack of funds to attract teachers in the government schools. Fourth one is about the renaming of Ross, Havelock and Neil Island of Andaman Nicobar. And the final one is about the Home Ministry's new order in the domain of license to snoop. The first article we'll be seeing is Iran sees revival of Lake Urmia. This article was taken from the newspaper Indian Express. Lake Urmia is a saltwater lake. So this saltwater lake is located in the country of Iran, close by to Caspian Sea. So this lake, it gets its source from almost 13 river bodies. And in the recent years, the lake has shrunk to about 10% of its original volume. This lake is also a lake of international importance under the Ramsar Convention. However, due to increasing anthropogenic activities, the lake is under severe threat. The lake is affected by severe prolonged drought as well as over-farming. Construction of dams in the nearby rivers, which acts as the feeder for this lake, is also one of the important reasons acting as threat to the shrinkage of this river. And according to United Nations sources, this river has shrunk from 2,300 square kilometers to just 700 square kilometers in 3 years alone. The next article we'll be seeing is rat hole coal mining in the state of Meghalaya. The problem of unregulated rat hole mining, which is also unscientific, has been going on in the region of Khasi Jaintia as well as Garo Hills in the state of Meghalaya for quite some time now. This unscientific procedure not just poses a threat to environment by causing environment pollution, especially to the water bodies, but it also has a potential to increase the vulnerability for disasters like landslides. In order to mitigate these, the National Green Tribunal in the year 2015 has asked the government of Meghalaya to suspend rat hole mining as well as the transportation of coal in the entire state. However, in spite of the ban, the procedure of rat hole mining is still continuing in the state of Meghalaya, which is manifested with the current issue of 15 workers trapped in a rat hole mines recently in the state of Meghalaya. So in this context, we have to know what rat hole mining is. So, rat hole mining is a method of mining which involves digging pits from 5 to 100 meters square into the ground. From the pits, tunnels are dug in and they are extended horizontally for excavation of coal seams. The coal is taken from the tunnel and it is dumped by the nearby unmined area, which poses great threat to the environment. So what is the impact of this rat hole mining? So the impact of rat hole mining can be broadly classified into three categories. One is the harmful impacts at the individual level. It causes great damage to health of the workers involved in rat hole mining. Second is the environmental impact. And third one is the geographical impact. This rat hole mining greatly affects the quality of water in the region. Because of the rat hole mining, it increases the leakage of the harmful heavy metals into the nearby area, thereby causing organic enrichment as well as silting of coal. This causes water pollution and it also indirectly affects the health of the people consuming the water. This rat hole mining also affects the whole aquatic ecosystem. Because of the increasing leakage of harmful metals into the water, this leakage of harmful material into the water bodies is manifested with the change in color of water to brownish and reddish orange. Because of this, the level of dissolved oxygen in the water bodies decrease. This dissolved oxygen is highly essential for the survival of the aquatic species in the water bodies. Because of the decrease in the dissolved oxygen in the water bodies, the aquatic animals can die of suffocation. The water bodies in Meghalaya also show increasing signs of sulfate as well as toxic heavy metals. Meghalaya, which is a part of Eastern Himalayas, is an ecologically sensitive zone as well as it is a biodiversity hotspot. So activities such as rat hole coal mining can pose serious threat to the stability of the whole Eastern Himalayan ecosystem. So it is high time that the mining policy which was drafted in the year 2012 is brought into implementation in the state of Meghalaya. The next article we'll be seeing is funds not enough to attract teachers to the government schools. This article was taken from the paper Hindu. So education is a very important tool for development as well as social change. So in order to bring in an inclusive education, the government has implemented 86th constitutional amendment in the year 2002, wherein it made education for children from the age group of 6 to 14 a fundamental right via implementation of Article 21A. It also made into force Right to Education Act to implement the provisions of Article 21A. So recently a report was made jointly by Child Rights and You as well as Center for Budget and Government Accountability to check the implementation of the Right to Education Act in 6 states including West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Meghalaya from the period 2015 to 2018. So one of the most important finding of the report is that the funds devolved by the center to the states in order to attract teachers in for the government school to provide better education as well as implementation of Right to Education Act is not sufficient. Though on one hand, center has led to overall increase in revenue via implementation of the 14th Finance Commission recommendation from 32% to 42%. On the other hand, it also reduced the contribution to the states for the central schemes in social sectors. Because of this, the states find it difficult to pay the teachers and they are not able to implement the 1:30 ratio which is mandated under the Right to Education Act in the government schools. So education is a very important tool for social change and proper availability of quality teachers is very much essential for providing this good quality education. So United Nations Sustainable Development Goal number 4 also calls for bringing in inclusive education, for which India needs to bring in serious changes in its education policy. The next article we'll be seeing is Ross Island is now Netaji Dweep. So the Prime Minister of India recently renamed Tree Island Group in the Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar. So Ross Island is renamed as Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Island, the Neel Island as Shahadeep Island and the Havelock Island as Swaraj Deep Island. So these three island group in Andaman Nicobar are very important tourist spot in the island. So UPSC asks the location of these island in map questions. So it is imperative for you to understand the location of Ross, Havelock as well as Neel Island in Andaman and Nicobar group. So the Ross Island is located close to Port Blair, which is capital of Andaman here. And Havelock Island is located here and followed by Neel Island. UPSC may also ask you to arrange the island group in north to south or east to west direction. So all these three islands are located in Andaman group of islands. The final article for the day is no agency has license to snoop. Last week the Home Ministry has issued an order designating 10 central agencies including CBI, Intelligence Bureau and Income Tax Department to intercept as well as monitor the information of any electronic device within India. This order issues serious criticisms from different groups as it stands against the right to privacy bestowed on citizens under Article 21 of Indian Constitution. It also directly stands against the various Supreme Court judgments on right to privacy. So in this issue, the government has again reinforced that the government is not giving any blanket power to any agency to intercept information from any computer. So the Home Ministry also emphasized that these agencies will strictly adhere to the rules provided by the government of India and the privacy of any individual will not be put under threat. Only authorized as well as designated agencies can go for interception as well as monitoring the information from the electronic devices of individuals. And it also ensured that there will not be any misuse of the personal data of individuals.